Hey Cancer, welcome to your November 2017 Tarotscope reading. This is Lauren with the Clarity Cure. Welcome back. Nice to see you and a warm welcome to all my new subscribers. I hope you guys had a wonderful October and thank you for becoming a part of my community here on YouTube. I'm really excited to be able to share these readings with you, and when we connect energetically, we build this like-minded space. And you're more than likely to hear specific messages for yourself. So thank you again. I will be offering an additional 10 minutes to any reading that's purchased through November 11th. That's like a $40 value. And that would be for either the Skype reading or the video reading. I kept it real simple. When you go to my book now button, there's two options. So you can have any kind of reading you want, which actually is leading me into this speaking about this wonderful life purpose spread that I have perfected. And it's just wonderful reading. It's a great way to kind of see where you are on your journey, what maybe you need to work on, what avenue is best for you in your life and your personality, and almost like what is your destiny. So think about it. I will extend some additional time, like I mentioned earlier, to any reading that's purchased, including the Life Purpose Spread. The mid-November readings are going to be replaced with the yearly 2018 forecast per each sign. So I'm really excited to do that. I'm going to actually get started on those as soon as I'm done here with the traditional overall November reading. So that's going to be really great. Make sure you tune in to see what's ahead for you in the year. And let's see, what else do I want? Oh, many of you signed up for my guided meditation. It is complimentary. But you filled out the wrong form. There's a yellow box. When you go to my contact page on my website, the link is below. Make sure you fill out the yellow box. Then you automatically will get the guided meditation, and then you can download it or listen to it however you want to use it that's best for you. But make sure you fill out that form. I emailed a lot of people back, and I didn't hear. So again, I apologize for the confusion. There is two forms on my contact page. So yellow box, I figured that would probably be the best way to, have you guys kind of focus and see that, okay? And I think that's it. So let's jump into the reading. When I was shuffling the cards, I kept getting this vision of you being surrounded by like these pockets of lights kept like shining through. So I'm not sure what that means, but we'll jump in here and see what we have. It looks like an extremely positive reading, Cancer. So a lot of major arcana. So a lot of things are going on behind the scenes, beyond your control, kind of meant to be kind of stuff that has to, matriculate or work through the process in order for you to move forward. But a lot of new beginnings. Treasure Island, I'm still new to these cards, but I think this is fabulous. I think this is you moving into your purpose, what you really want to do, speaking about purpose. But let's start at the beginning. The overall energy you received moving into November is the King of Wands. And this is a very mature, fiery kind of energy. This king takes a leadership role. He's extremely goal-orientated. He's like what you consider like a visionary, so he has a lot of maturity here, and he's a manifester. He knows how to make things happen. So this energy is coming in. Let's see how it plays into the reading for you. I see at the heart of the reading here, you have the Emperor. So a lot of masculine energy, meaning that you need to take, we're not messing around here, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. This is an authority figure. This card represents the situation overall. So this is potentially an Aries person, someone with a solid foundation. It could be like a father or a boss, maybe even an older person in your life. This emperor knows how to take control and he steps up to the plate. You know, there could be some energy here, like his blessing is needed in order for you to move forward, or his help in some way. Let's see what this card is. Crossing you, you have the Hanged Man. And this is you being in a suspended kind of position. As you can see, this is depicted by being hung upside down. So this is like, you know, that wait period or letting go, maybe having to make a sacrifice. Maybe this is like you waiting, like feeling restricted. Like maybe you haven't been able to step up to the plate or take back your power because you've been in a place of ultimate surrender. You know, sometimes this means breaking old habits as well. So hang in there. A delayed decision could be the hell hold up here as well. But I feel this is you seeking clarity. So you can step up to the plate, you know, so you can find your vision, your dreams, your goals, focus on what you want. You're in a place, okay, of new beginnings. So it looks like you just might have to have this, get over this hurdle, this part here of maybe taking a step back. Because usually the hangman, this is like a voluntary action. It's not a space where, like with the Four of Swords, sometimes, you know, you're forced to rest, right? So this could be you wanting to spend some time alone and being, you know, opening up your mind to some new perspectives, maybe working on your purpose. You know, I see that here with the Hierophant. So there's a lot of soul searching going on here for you for the month of November. And astrologically speaking, there's a lot of optimism coming in for you, kind of like a rebirth period. I'm trying to remember what planets are aligning with you, but I know Venus conjuncts Jupiter in your house of relationships. So I think this is a time for you to find your joy in the world, find your purpose. I think there's going to be a lot of positive energy coming in for you. You know, a lot of the planets are moving forward, and I think for a lot of the different signs, what I've noticed, there's been just a lot of, I wouldn't say struggle, but just a lot of huge growth spurts. And we're seeing some relief in November, which is fabulous, okay? At the base of your reading, you have the Temperance, and this is kind of what's led you up to this place. So, you know, it looks like you've been super balanced. You know, this is a very spiritual card as well. This is about divine timing. You were inspired, okay, to get on the right path, to go with the flow and not push or force a situation. So maybe you're still kind of in this place where you're trying to find your balance, trying to get your clarity, you know, tapping into some creativity here. And it's interesting because you don't want to be rushed, yet you want to kind of find your clarity because this is like crossing you. But let's see what happens in the immediate future. I think you're going to be moving forward. I'd say by the middle of November, you're going to find your stride, okay, and you're going to be able to move forward. But, you know, I feel like this journey has been some kind of divine intervention. Because the Temperance is all about timing, you know, patience being required. It's almost like a healing energy. Like, and with all these major arcana here, I feel like you've been kind of like held back or restricted energetically in some way. And I'm trying to remember your last reading. I could have sworn you had the Hierophant and some similar cards. I could be wrong, but overall, this still is an amazing reading for you guys. So let's just keep moving forward. In your recent past, you have the Six of Cups, and this is you feeling nostalgic. This is thinking about your past, maybe memories, maybe even some old feelings bubbling up. You know, sometimes we're tested. Even this is a really super positive card. It's like a soulmate card. It goes deeper than that. Sometimes we need to reflect back, but you don't want to hold on to those memories. Like things may bubble up and we're like, why am I thinking about that? Or why am I thinking about that person? But, you know, it's for a reason. I mean, maybe there's part here, a part of you in your heart that needs to heal from something from the past. This could be fond memories as well. This could be super positive. I don't see any negative cards here. So enjoy it. You know, you're coming from a place where you maybe had some lessons, had some divine spiritual guidance. This could even be from with a, maybe a old karmic relationship coming in to actually help you, or you deciding what you want, you know, because this is kind of like a soulmate card, you know, and it is about good relationships and being with somebody that's a good match, you know. So make sure that if there's any old ideas that pop up, you release those, you acknowledge them, you don't try to suppress them. Okay, look at yourself objectively, and if there's any old wounds that are popping up, maybe look at that as well. And 'cause I think, you know, Leo really, really had it hard with the eclipse season. I think you guys struggled as well, you know. So you have to live your life for what you want, okay? And you definitely don't want to live in the past. You want that new vision. You want to, you know, grab on to those feelings of optimism that are going to be coming in for you for November, and bring that joy into the world. You know, you're a water sign. You get it. You matriculate very close to your feelings. So I would embrace that, okay? The best that could be hoped for in the situation and the best outcome is the Eight of Pentacles. So this is you working very hard. I think that you've put the time and effort in, you know. So now you want to connect with others. You know, you want to kind of reassess, okay, what is the best for you? Like maybe relearning some things, assessing your situation, coming up with new solutions, rebuilding and mastering new skills. You know, and this can be an improvement in career, work, finances. This is a Pentacles card, so it's usually about the material matters, work, business, money, and prosperity, and all that. This is you putting the effort in, okay? And now you're waiting to see, okay, what's going to happen now, you know? Sometimes, and there's a very similar energy here, and the message that I'm getting is about going deep, deep inside, okay? Knowing that something has to change, knowing those answers, okay, are deep within your psyche, okay, that... you know, we know what works for us and what doesn't. So you definitely don't want to slip in the past. You don't want to, you know, go back to this place if there's any negative emotions here. And you want to rebuild and you want to move forward, okay? So there's a lot of connection here between these two cards, okay? I think finding new ways that work for you, almost like an apprenticeship mind, right? This is somebody that wants to find new ways to build their future moving forward, okay? Even though it's the Eight, okay? It's about assessing where we are, how we can do things better. And in your immediate future, and about halfway through the month, is the Queen of Pentacles. Okay, and this is a Earth sign Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn person that could be in your life or coming into your life to assist you maybe with some things. But, you know, she teaches us the balance. She's like the ultimate Mother Earth, but she's also the career woman. She has it all. She knows how to take responsibility for her finances and her family. She's very nurturing. And she knows how to be successful, okay, through her achievements and her accomplishments. So I feel like, you know, this is a very successful car for you, and you're going to find your way into this energy and maybe find that stable income that you've been looking for, or more time to nurture your relationship with your loved ones, you know. But, you know, balance is key, right? Balance, balance, balance is really coming up for a lot of the signs this month for November. So this is making something a reality. I love the Queen of Pentacles. She's amazing. She knows how to make something reality. She sees the rewards and she goes for it. Okay, so great energy for you, Cancer, and that's coming in to guide you. Your power in this situation is the Seven of Wands. And this is you, you know, standing up for yourself, fighting for what you believe in. Maybe you've had some struggles, you know, but this is about what you want. So I feel like you know, I don't know if there's maybe somebody influencing you to do something one way and you just don't want to, like with the Emperor here and the King of Wands. There could be just a lot of people here poking their nose in. Honestly, this is another way to look at it, on your business and telling you, oh, you need to do this or you need to do that. I mean, this Emperor could be a boss or somebody pushing you to, like I said, go one route, but you're like, no, you know, I'm not going to settle down. I know what my vision is. This is what I want to do for me. I'm willing to fight for what I believe in. Now, this could be very defensive energy as well. It can go the other way. This could be you being very defensive. But I think for the most part, you know, this is about progress. Okay, going back to the Eight of Pentacles here, very similar energy, right? Assessing your progress and reviewing and determining what is the best course of action for me. Which way do I need to be going? Is the message here. Loud and clear. That's what I'm getting. Ooh, serious. It's funny because there's a lot of, like, I feel like there's a lot of serious energy here for you, Cancer. You're these loving, you know, water sign. And it's not like it's bad. It's just, wow, you know, with all these major arcana, this is just like, and I think you're even excited too. I feel this energy of anticipation of growth coming for you. So this is just wonderful. In not your hopes and fears, but in your how others see you, okay, is the Nine of Cups. So this is beautiful, loving energy here. This is almost, you know, at that point of completion where, you know, you're getting, you know, it's happening for you, okay? This anticipation, others see you're reveling, right, in your growth, okay? I call it the wish card, so people see that you're getting your wish, and you are moving through, and things are changing for you, Cancer, and now moving along, you know, about you being happy and growing and being creative. I mean, astrologically, some wonderful energy coming in for you. You're ruled by the moon. I'm trying to think. The moon is it in Taurus, I think? I apologize. Don't quote me on that. But regardless, this is just a great place for you to be in November. It's going to be wonderful energy for you. The Nine of Cups. So getting back to that, let me think here. I lost my focus here for a minute. Your ultimate wish card. Others see you getting your wish. Now, this could be sometimes overindulgence. Now, there definitely is, your health is being highlighted astrologically for November, okay? So don't overeat. Don't overdrink. Don't overindulge too much. Watch your weight, you know, your health habits. Wait, because you, with this kind of energy, you can definitely put on the pounds and all of a sudden you're like, oh my goodness, you know, what happened and the holidays are coming. So I am hearing that health is real critical, okay? Even though I know this is how others are seeing you, I'm getting these other messages, okay? You need to focus on your health. Maybe it's been tough for you to stay, what's the word I'm looking for, with a routine, okay? So just keep that in mind. I think you're going to now, with all these planets moving forward, all of a sudden feel like, you know what? Yeah, I'm ready. I'm going to stick to this plan. I'm going to go to the gym. I'm going to do what I need to do and get my health in order, okay? So very, very important here with the Nine of Cups. And let's see. So we have in your hopes and fears, well, another major arcana for you. Cancer, this is just beautiful. This is like the ultimate victory card, you in the driver's seat. Possibly being faced with two decisions or two directions to go. Like maybe you're thinking, oh, maybe I'll, you know, I want to do this kind of career, but, you know, I might end up, you know, doing this job instead or something like that, having your own business or working for somebody else kind of thing. It is a very empowering energy. This is you, actually. You know, the Chariot is represented by Cancer, and I know definitely for sure you had this in your mid October readings for sure. It's very similar energy from what I can remember, but this is taking action, and you're going to be able to do that, Cancer. It's definitely not a negative card. This is definitely a hope. Obviously, it's a very positive card. So this is about going to the next level. This is over and above kind of what, where you've been, if that makes sense. Like, you know, being faced with that, which way am I going to go in my life? But it's being victorious over any obstacles, but having the power to choose, right? It's you in the driver's seat, you getting a handle on those reins, so to speak, you know, balancing your yin and your yang, you know. So here we were worried about, you know, making sure you were balanced. And with the Hanged Man, of course, you know, finding your clarity. And this is the holdup right now, but you're going to be able to get over this hurdle. You're going to find your clarity. Even this reading could even help you, you know, kind of sort out your thoughts and help you kind of get out of that restriction, maybe feeling that you're having right now, you know. Yeah, because I'm recording these at the end of October, and we're now just moving into November, so you're going to feel a lot better in November for sure. But this is wonderful. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five major arcana in this spread. And actually, 6, because you have new beginnings, and that's the Fool. So this is you taking a huge leap of faith, Cancer, in your life and choosing to make change. And I think this like the pockets of light or kind of like this abyss that I saw you coming in over you while I was meditating. And your final outcome card, interesting, is the Hierophant. And honestly, for you in this reading, I really, really feel this is about you finding your purpose, honestly. This card is represented by a very religious figure. He's like the highest pope, right? A religious being that can be, as well as, we don't have the, I'm sorry, the... Don't worry about it. Never mind. I'm a little tired. I thought you maybe you had the other spiritual card here, the High Priestess, but you don't. But anyway, you know, I feel this is you searching for that meaning in your life. Yes, this is a religious figure. Yes, this is a very conventional card. This is about you kind of coloring in the lines and following social norms. But there's a lot of different meanings to this card. This gentleman represents wise counsel. This could be a priest or a spiritual mentor in your life. This is somebody that could be coming in, maybe a Taurus person, coming in to help you as a mentor. You may even feel compelled to join a group, maybe to expand your interest in, you know, deciding which direction you want to go. But I think you have a lot of beautiful opportunities coming in with Treasure Island, and we're going to read this meaning. But I think this is you finding that, like, golden key to your future here. Okay, finding your way in the treasure map, so to speak. So the Hierophant speaks to having faith and tapping into that purpose, tapping into it. Hold on, I got to sneeze. Oh, excuse me. I'm so sorry. You know, you being compelled to find that deeper meaning in life. It's all over the spread here. Okay, the Hangman, the Temperance. Okay. It's beautiful. So let's just pull you a quick, a couple of additional clarifiers real quick here for you. I mean, I don't really see that there's anything really needs to be clarified. But let's see what the cards say. I'm a little curious about you being in this space. Where this Emperor is. You know, there's no aces, there's no pages. Let's see here. You know, maybe for some of you, I'm picking up on these cards fell out, but they were face down, so I'm still going to shuffle them. Maybe some of you have lost a job and you're kind of reassessing what you want to do as well. That's an option here. Okay. What are the messages for Cancer? Okay. Four of Swords. And I think I was talking about that earlier today. I mean, earlier in the reading here about getting rest. Page of Pentacles. Here we go. Here's some nice energy for you coming in. I just said I don't see any pages here. Well, there you go. King of Cups. Here you are. Look at you, Cancer. Representing. Beautiful. Very nice. And the Knight of Rods. So definitely a lot of movement's going to be happening for you in your new endeavors here and your new beginnings, moving into a new phase of your life, feeling better, getting the rest that you need. So take some time out in the next week, week and a half before November kicks in. Okay, because you've got a lot of new business coming in, not a lot of new activity, and you're going to be kind of moving through November doing a lot of soul searching and deciding, okay, which way to go in your life. Let's see. So the Page of Pentacles. You know, this is that go-ahead. Okay, you're going to receive some kind of correspondence, some communication about a new beginning. This is could be initial stage of a project, maybe a hobby that you love that you want to turn into a business venture. You know, this page is holding, you know, his money here. So this could be, you know, news about a financial opportunity or, you know, maybe you deciding, you know, going back to school. For each one of you, it's going to be a little different. But this is about being super enthusiastic, you know, very similar to the Fool here, taking that leap of faith. I think that something's going to come in and you're going to decide, you know what? I could do A or B, but I think I'm going to be victorious here. And out of these two choices, okay, out of a couple of different opportunities, I know exactly what I'm going to do. So this is really, really exciting energy for you, Cancer. Let's see. So back to the page. Let me think. What was I saying? Yeah, so this is also, you know, that generating wealth for your future, okay, meaning this page is the most entrepreneurial spirit, okay? So, you know, the Fool comes in and he's taken that first step, so he's not sure yet where he's going. That's why they say, you know, watch your step with the Fool, because it's not like you're not paying attention where you're going. You're just at the very, very early stages, okay? But you have this stability here of the Page of Pentacles along with the Fool. So I think you're going to know exactly what you want to do. You're going to know exactly where you're going. And here with this page is, this is like you getting paid for your work, okay? Like the Ace of Pentacles, the Page of Pentacles, I feel that, you know, as long as you take action, okay, you're going to be able to move forward in a positive way, okay, where it's the results will be longer lasting, if that makes sense. Okay, so seize any opportunity that you get. Don't let it fall by the wayside or fizzle out, because, you know, with this energy coming in for you, it's supporting you. Okay, now I know some Cancers might be in different places, you know, depending on the stage of your life. So this could even apply to something as simple as a hobby. So don't look at it as just, you know, one opportunity for a career or anything like that. So you'll know if it resonates with you. Okay, and then what else do we have here for you? Yeah, some more messages coming in. I mean, here you are. Look at you in the middle here. Okay, this is you, Cancer. And look what you're surrounded by. Okay, I feel like this page isn't looking at you, but I feel like the information's coming in. You're getting it, and you're moving forward. Isn't that something? So the Knight of Rods, well, you better hold on to your hat, because, you know, he's another deliverer of information. You know, this is about change and superpower, meaning super speed coming in and offer coming in. So be prepared, because you're going to want to pursue this idea, and it's going to be fast moving, and you're going to be, yeah, let's do it, okay? I'm ready. I'm ready to make this leap of faith in my life and change my life and move forward and watch my weight and get on top of that and, you know, harness, okay, this energy of taking back my power and or being in a leadership role. I mean, the biggest message with both these cards is being in a leadership role, okay? Treasure Island. Let's read that real fast. We know what the Fool means. Treasure Island. Oh, yeah, I pulled the page already. You've worked hard and acted upon your unwavering belief in abundance, and suddenly, in the midst of it all, you hit the jackpot. You have uncovered the map to your buried treasure and tapped the unlimited potential within you. What you must hone now is your ability to recognize when X marks the spot, because some of those golden opportunities may be obvious, but others may not be so readily apparent. Trust your intuition. Okay, so I think we're hearing that here, okay, with the Hierophant. And light, intuition to light your way. Oh, those are the pockets of lights I was seeing. To light your way as you enter this truly prosperous phase, where all along hard work navigating your inner life is now paying off externally. Oh, that is so amazing. Don't forget to enjoy and share it with others, as treasure shares multiples like magic. Wow, that's really amazing. So I think what I was saying earlier too, like There may be more than one opportunity. I think you're going to find your way to make that proper decision, okay, of what opportunity you want, okay? You're going to have a lot of information coming in. There's going to be a lot of flurrying and busyness going on around you, Cancer. So I think it's just fabulous. This is a wonderful reading. I wish you all the best for November. I hope this reading resonated with all of you. Please give it a thumbs up. And thank you for liking, sharing, subscribing. And we'll see you mid-month for the 2018 forecast readings. Take care. Bye-bye.